Really good to be here. I know for everyone on the team, we could be in a lot of places, but being here in front of you is where we want to be the most. And it's where we want to be the most because it's a chance to ask bold questions of each other. I know all of us in the team, when we first started, were asked a bold question by Selena. And that question was, what is your unchanging promise? There's a lot going on in life. There are a lot of demands. There are a lot of things you've got to attend to. But what is your unchanging promise? What are those things that you adhere to so deeply that they firm the bedrock of who you're going to be and where we're going to go? Well, for us, as a food company, this is our unchanging promise. It's to answer this question. And I want you to think about it with me. What would the world look like? What would it look like if healthier food was affordable? What would the world really look like if we could figure out a way to feed 9.5 billion people on this planet without degrading the environment? What would the world look like if food that was healthy, a food that was radically affordable, was also food that was safer? What would it look like if delicious food was radically affordable and sustainable? How would it change things? How would it change the dynamics of healthcare in this country? How would it change and strengthen our environment? What would we do together if we were bold enough to answer this question? And this is the goal of Hampton Creek, to spend every single day attempting to create the answer. And this is how we do it. We've created a technology platform that screens through the world's plants. Plants that we've heard of, plants that we haven't heard of. And this methodology, this screening platform, has enabled us to identify a number of plants out there that actually enable food to be better, to be healthier, to be stronger, to be safer. And we could have started with a lot of places, but we decided to start with identifying one element of our food system that we think has a particular set of issues, and that is the conventional chicken egg. Lots of them are laid, requires an amazing amount of resources, lots of water, lots of land, food safety issues, and we found plants that are more compelling than the chicken egg, safer, more affordable, and that is just the start. And as Mr. Lee can attest, it's also pretty good too. And it was one of the most special moments of my life to be able to scramble the world's first plant-based egg for Mr. Lee, and everything went perfectly, I think, until I overcooked it. But next time, I know to get a little bit better. So this quest to answer this question has forced us to think anew. It's forced us not to try to iterate and make things a tiny little bit better, because after all, if you're trying to build a transportation system for the 21st century, you don't try to make the horse and buggy a little bit better. You don't try to iterate on the gas light. You think about electricity. You think about leaping over. And for us, it's about thinking anew. It's about asking ourselves, what would we do if we really just started this thing from scratch? We've been fortunate enough to have been named one of three companies shaping the future of food by Bill Gates because of this approach to innovation. We've been lucky enough to share our story all across the world. It's not just about a product. It's not just about a technology. It's about a movement of people that believe food can be better, that believe it doesn't have to be premium, healthy food for premium people that make a lot of money, that the real way to change the world is to make food accessible for all, to make the good, healthy food accessible for everyone. And this isn't just a question that we're answering in our own head. It's a question we're answering in the marketplace today, because 7 Fortune 500 companies around the world have said they want to answer it with us. Walmart, General Mills, the largest grocery stores in America, have said they buy into this, the idea that we can do this together. Now, traction is good, and a movement is good, but I want to take you a little bit inside the technology that enables this to happen. When we first started this, we had an idea of starting a new kind of food company, a food company that could really boldly answer the question, and our first instinct was to act like we're one of the big guys, and that's what the picture on the left is. Have some food scientists, maybe have a chef, and after trying, kind of banging my head against the wall for all too long, we realized that we really need to think differently. And today we have a team of computational biologists, of molecular biologists, of biochemists, of food scientists, of chefs, who all get together in a multidisciplinary way to create a platform that looks at the world's plants. We've looked at over 3,200 plants, identified 11, over 43 countries around the world we've scanned through, and when we bring these plants into our lab, we look at their biochemical properties. This is one of them, the molecular weight of a particular varietal's protein. And we build a database of all of these plants and all of the species and all of these varietals and a set of biochemical properties that enables us, much like a search engine, to have a better algorithm for food so we can ultimately commercialize things that make things better. Now, I'm going to pause a little bit on this slide because I want to take you a little bit deeper into the technology, into the science. You have a protein gel depicting one plant species here. This is a Canadian yellow pea. And there are over 2,000 varietals of a Canadian yellow pea. You find one varietal on the left and another varietal on the right. Now, the traditional food think is that the functionalities, the biochemical properties of varietals within the species are exactly the same. And that would be exactly wrong. Because there is an abundance, a complexity, a diversity inside the world's plant species that for some reason, we just forgot about it. And our technology enables us to remember. Because the molecular weight for the varietal on the left is different than the one on the right. And as such, the functionality of how the varietal works is different. And this functionality here depicts the functionality of emulsion. So I go back to chicken eggs again. 1.8 trillion of them are laid around the world, and a third of them are used inside food products. They're used to bring oil and water together. They're used to aerate baked goods, to bind together cookies. Well, this one enables that functionality of emulsion to happen, where the one on the right doesn't. And as our database grows and gets bigger, we see implications not only in food, but maybe even outside food too. Now, you might ask, why the chicken egg? I mean, of all places you could have started, why mess with the world's cheapest, most abundant source of animal protein? Well, there are a few reasons. The first is that chicken egg prices are rising, and they're rising because the process of chicken egg production is insanely inefficient. 70% of the cost of every chicken egg comes from the feed that the chickens eat. And all that feed requires all of this land and all of this water and all of this fertilizer and all of this oil, which is why intensive animal agriculture is responsible for 18% of the world's greenhouse gas emissions. Now, you can look at that as someone who cares about the environment and say, we should do something different. You could look at that as someone who cares about food safety and think maybe we should do something different. Or you could just look at it as a capitalist and say, let's do something more efficient. Other reasons that we think it's a good place to go after, health. In my country, about 43% of Americans are trying to reduce or limit cholesterol entirely from their diet. We think a new methodology built around a platform of plants can enable food holistically to be healthier, and we think that's an extremely good thing. More and more people do care about sustainability in their food. It's not to be neglected. Less water, less greenhouse gas emissions. Food safety is a big one, because it doesn't take a genius to realize that when you put lots of birds in lots of tiny cages, that often they get sick. And often when they get sick, that propagates issues like avian flu. And if we were just trying to build a food system for the 21st century, we might want to mitigate the probability of something like that happening. We don't just have to use horse and buggies anymore. We can leap over and begin to use cars in our food system. The final thing being allergies. Lots of people are allergic, and we think we can build food that's not only healthier and affordable, but is also easier to access for people who have allergies. Meet the coal-fired chicken. Part of the reason chicken egg production is so inefficient, as I alluded to, is that the food-to-energy ratio of chicken egg production is so out of whack, 39 to 1. What we do with this new paradigm of technology is radically better, 2 to 1. food safety. Just look at the top right as capitalists. For a moment, put aside the health of an economy. For a moment, put aside environmental issues and just think as a capitalist. What kind of food system would we build if an issue like avian flu caused a giant company's profits to drop by over 21%? We would think about doing it differently to provide insurance against a growing economy. Now, I think change in a dramatic, in a bold way, comes from being better across a number of parameters. Not just better tasting, not just lasting longer, but also radically more affordable. And today, we are 48% more cost effective than the cheapest chicken egg. Tomorrow, we'll be 75%. The next day, we'll be 97%. In the same way that the car is 10 times better than the horse and buggy, we're going to create food that's 10 times better than the status quo. How does this materialize into products today? Well, we make products like mayo that's selling like crazy in the United States. We're actually launching with Park and Shop in Hong Kong here in about 7 days. We're able to make baked goods that normally require massive amounts of chicken eggs to fuel their functionality. And you might be asking yourself, well, that's nice. Ingredients for baked goods. You can make products like cookies. But after all, we did see Mr. Lee scrambling a plant-based egg. What does the future hold there? So I want to show you a quick clip of what one of the world's top chefs had to say when he visited our lab and did the same thing Mr. Lee did.
You're close. No wonder you're so excited.
I mean, this is so hard. I mean, this is the hardest thing.
No doubt.
No doubt.
Yeah, this is definitely the hardest thing.
Yeah, you're close.
I've had the privilege of seeing a lot of things in my lifetime as a culinarian and in the last 10 years making television. What I've seen today is earth-changing.
I think bold questions, what is your unchanging promise? Bold questions, what would the world look like if healthier food was affordable? Require bold answers, but they require them to be answered together. And I'd love to do that with you. Thanks for listening.